Hey, what's going on? This is Don, and welcome to another quick tip for Cinema 4D. And today I want to show you how you can take any geometry in your scene and control it with MoGraph. So I am working on this scene for one of my upcoming projects, and I thought I would just quickly show you a few interesting things. Okay, so this is a parking lot scene, and one of the models that's in the scene are these bins or trash cans. Okay, so I can solo these, and we have 12 of them, and these are just normal objects. You know, they are not your usual MoGraph objects like the cloner, which you can easily control using the effectors. So here's what you can do. You can there's a couple of ways you can do this. You can take everything, first of all, and drop all of these separate objects into a fracture. And this will automatically turn everything into MoGraph objects now. So if, for example, I click on the fracture, go to MoGraph and effector, let's get their random effector. And now you can see that we are controlling these using the standard MoGraph tools. Okay, so that's one way. Another way is you could use a cloner instead of a fracture. So let me show you the setup for that. If I go to MoGraph and cloner, and again, let's do the same thing, just drag everything into the cloner. And we just have to set the count to be the same as the number of objects that we started with. So it was 12. And we're in this default linear mode, which by default moves each clone in steps of 50. So let's set this back down to 0, which brings them back to their original positions. Again, make sure the count is the same, because if I drop this to say 11, we lose the last clone. And if we have any more than 12, we end up creating extra clones which stack on top of the original ones. Okay, but again, now I can go to MoGraph effector, and let's get the step effector this time, just to have a bit of variety. And now you can see we are affecting the original objects with MoGraph. Now you're wondering why you might not just set up, you know, this kind of thing in a cloner to begin with. Well, this kind of distribution in a cloner would be not that straightforward to do, where you've got, you know, either groups of two like this, you know, six times, or groups of four, three times. You would not have the individual control over each object in your cloner without a lot of setup. So the point is, you can have your objects in custom positions, you know, lay them out however you want. And if it's not your usual pattern that you can achieve with a cloner, you can still bring everything into a cloner and be able to control them anyway. Something which may happen, which didn't happen here, is your clones may not be in the correct position, or their rotation will be different to what they were initially. In which case, you just have to go to fix clone and untick this, and that will bring back everything to what it should be. So just an interesting technique which you might find interesting. Let's go back a step here. I want to go back to the fracture object, which I think in this case would actually be the easier method, because you know, you just drop everything into the fracture. And based on the fact that whatever you drag in there is a separate object in your object manager here, the fracture will almost work just as a cloner. And again, you can control everything using MoGraph. Okay, one more way that you can affect any object in Cinema 4D using the standard MoGraph tools is by using the effectors as deformers on your geometry. So let's grab a different model here. We have these ramps inside the center of the parking lot. And I can take a deformer, for example, And this is how deformers work. If you put them in a hierarchy in a null like this, they will affect whatever is in the same null. So this can be at the top or at the base of your hierarchy. So let's see, it's still going to work. I've never tried to actually just place it anywhere in the middle. So it seems that as long as it's in the same hierarchy as any geometry you're trying to deform, this will have an effect. So you can actually also do this with effectors. So if I go to MoGraph and effector, again, let's get the random. That is probably the most used effector, as you can tell. And we'll drag this into the same hierarchy. And for this to work, we need to go to the deformer tab. And by default, it's set to off. So we need to change this to be one of these other three. Object is going to affect the entire object at the base level. So it just moves everything as one piece. And we can change this to, let's say, point, which will now start affecting your geometry at the point level. So, you know, you wouldn't do this kind of thing because this looks strange. But let's say you were working with a sphere, for example. So let's actually make this a child of the sphere, which is another way to affect whatever you're working with. It can either be a child of a singular object like this, or if you have multiple objects, you put everything into a null and do it that way instead. But now you see with the sphere in the point mode, we could go to the parameters, for example, and start animating these. Or in fact, if I go to effector, the random mode, I could set this to noise, which by default has animation. And now we're doing this this kind of thing. So using an effector on a non-MoGraph object, you know, but we go to the deformer tab here and set the deformation to be turned on and try these different modes and see what you can come up with. So that's it, you know, just another quick tip for Cinema 4D and how you can control typically non-MoGraph objects with Cinema 4D's MoGraph tools. If you have any questions or suggestions for future tutorials, then just leave some comments below. And don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss the next one. Also, check out the store, the texture packs for Cinema 4D, Car Paint, Element 3D, Sci-Fi Shaders, and so on. And of course, the new Octane texture packs. There's some of those too. But that's it for now, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.